Back in our area, two arrests tonight in the murder of a young local woman who had big dreams of becoming a lawyer. She was shot and left to die in the middle of a Wilkinsburg street. Action News reporter Bob Mayo spoke to the victim's mother and her sister. And Bob, this murder plot all started with a phone call.
A phone call for a jitney ride. She was driving as a jitney to make ends meet. And officials here at County Police Headquarters say they think whoever answered that call could have met the same fate. Her family now is struggling with the loss of this young woman in whom they had so much hope. 28-year-old Monica Proviano's mom and sister describe her big dreams to return to college, become a lawyer.
I used to tell her I didn't want her to jitney, and she said, Ma, she says, I got bills to pay.
But she was shot in the face and left in the middle of Trenton Avenue to die. Now police charge two 19-year-olds, Timothy Brock and William McGraw, with plotting to rob a jitney driver. By chance, that driver was Monica.
They're monsters. You know, how could you just plan something like that? That's premeditated.
Maybe it was the frustration of the two actors, if you want to call it that, that Monica didn't have what they thought she should have. And they figured at that point they'd just shoot her and just shot her.
Monica Proviano earned praise from professors at Carlo University. She and her sister Whitney shared dreams of law school, but she was making ends meet as a patient care technician and as a jitney.
She was loving, and she did everything she can do to help someone out. And she was an awesome sister and a great best friend, and just tons of people loved her.
She would tell me she knew it was dangerous. She says, but I'm okay. I could take care of me. And I said, what if somebody, you know, with a gun?
A police officer who taught her in high school remembers her, says Wilkinsburg's police chief.
She was a good student. Very pleasant young lady, and just a downright good citizen.
Brock and McGraw are being held in the Allegheny County Jail, waiting court appearances on this case. We can tell you that her family is sending messages of thanks to county police tonight, impressed that within a week after her killing, these two men are in custody, bringing what the family says is a feeling of a sense of justice for them. County Police Headquarters, Bob Mayo, Channel 4 Action News.